Hello, welcome to another episode of Naked Physical Therapy with Shane and Hannah.
Nope.
We're your hosts, Shane and Hannah. Now, as we always say, let's get nasty.
Nope.
I like this position because I can gesture.
I know, you
with my thumb. This is the only movement I have right here, but I am going to use it.
Use the hell out
of it. I'm going to use it till I lose it, as I like to say.
Nope.
Anyway, do you want to tell them what we're doing today?
Yeah. I want to apologize for what you're going to see. And second, we're going to be doing Shane's physical therapy. This was Shane's idea. He doesn't do his physical therapy very often.
Not as often as I should, that's for sure.
But I encouraged him to do it yesterday, so he did all of his stretches.
Yes.
And that he decided he wanted to film a video today showing you.
I thought it might be interesting.
Yeah.
To show you how I limber up.
Yep, and that has been requested a lot, especially by occupational therapists and physical therapists.
Yes, and these are just the stretches that we do for me. This is not medical advice by any means, so don't trust anything that we're doing.
Yep, this is not sanctioned by anyone. Shane does not have a physical therapist right now that has told us to do these things. So for all of you physical therapists that have requested this, I'm really sorry for what you're about to see.
And please don't tell us everything that we're doing wrong.
Yeah.
Or do. Maybe if you
have helpful.
If you have helpful advice, that would be good. But
yeah.
Here's what we do. Can I have one more pillow?
Oh my god.
Step one. Make sure the patient is extremely comfortable.
First of all, you're not my patient.
I need to be so comfortable that as Hannah is manipulating me, I can drift off into a peaceful sleep.
Alright, we're going to start with arms. Elbows. Shane taught me all these stretches when we first met. Over 4 years ago, I learned these.
The basic purpose of most of these stretches is just to maximize my range of motion.
Yeah.
As you can see, I can't really tell what they can see, but
they can see.
This is about the max that my elbow can open. Hannah is just supporting the top half.
Yep.
And pulling with her other arm towards
broadly, so as not to snap the bone.
Towards her body. You should imagine me a wishbone.
I did that joke yesterday. You literal thief.
I stole that.
You actually just stole that.
You called me out on it, too.
Oh, well, I wasn't. I could tell that you were just, like, hoping that I wasn't going to say anything.
Okay, pause.
I made the joke yesterday about the wishbone.
Pause. We won't put any of this in the edit.
No. Nope.
You say it again. Say the joke.
No.
Go ahead.
No.
Say what's rightfully yours.
No. I want everyone to know that you stole.
The other thing is, we go for long, like, prolonged, gentle stretches.
Yes.
Rather than, like, short, jerky.
Yeah.
I don't know if you ever do.
I don't know.
Short, jerky stretches.
Prolonged and gentle is the way to stretch.
Yeah.
It's, like, very normal.
And I communicate with Hannah about if it hurts, if I can go further.
Yeah, I haven't gotten any feedback.
No. It's horribly painful right now. All right, so that's the elbow. We can move to the hand.
Well, yesterday I did a new thing called shoulder range of motion.
Shoulder range of motion.
Shane said that this was absolutely not what a physical therapist would do, but I don't know. To me, it looks like...
Oh, something popped.
It looks like something that should be done. So I'm doing shoulder range of motion now where I just...
Can you move your right hand down towards my hand more? Keep it outward a little? And then, yeah.
Why?
It just feels better that way.
Huh.
We really do it based on feel.
Yep. My feel, your
if
feel.
If it feels, come on.
What happened?
Something in my wrist tinned.
Alright, we can do wrist now.
I felt lightning going through my wrist.
Oh boy, so now wrist, I just stabilize below Shane's wrist and I just pull his hand up.
Yep, a little bit more. A little bit more right there. Oh god. And because of my contractures, which is the lockedness of my wrist, these do not feel wonderful.
Yeah.
Like, it's not refreshing.
No.
Until I'm done. After we do this, it feels pretty good.
Yeah.
A little bit less. All right.
Communication.
While we're doing this, are you nervous that you're going to hurt me?
Nope.
Or were you in the beginning?
Oh. I think it meant like while we're filming that I would get it on film with me hurting you.
No, when you're doing my therapy.
No. I was at first, like the first couple times. Do you remember you used to have to be like harder, harder, harder because I would like not want to pull.
Now she just ignores my cries for help.
I was going to say, ignore any screams I hear.
My wrists are probably the most affected muscle area, maybe my hips.
Mm-hmm.
They are tight. So you show them what you're doing with your thumb. You were just rubbing.
I'm rubbing under his wrist.
Well, just explain why. Like,
well, I think that it does something to the tendons, gives them some extra loosenage, but I don't know if that is true.
Again, this is not medical advice. This is not sanctioned by...
It could be absolutely horrible for you, I don't know, but...
It does feel good.
Yeah.
Sometimes it hurts.
Yeah, it gives you some extra stretch.
All right, we can move on to the legs. Okay. For most of my life, I'm going to do my knee. All right. Anyway. This is like a weird video for all of you. Hannah just hurting me.
I'll pull your pants up.
No, I want
your thigh.
Can we use the leg that has the tattoo?
How about I just show them the tattoo? Does everyone know I
have a tattoo on my thigh?
Everyone knows that, Shane, and no one wants to see it. It's a dinosaur in a wheelchair, T-Rex.
Just show it off. I'm pretty sure they want the thigh. Anyway, for most of my life, I went to actual physical therapy, not in Hannah's House of Horrors.
Oh my God, literally, why am I here?
I went once a week, which was all that my insurance would pay for. And even that was a fight. Like, every 3 months, insurance would be like, "And you're done." And I'd have to prove again for the thousandth time that I needed ongoing physical therapy. So it was frustrating in that way. And doing it once a week was never enough to, like, really make any kind of progress on my muscles.
Yeah.
It was helpful. It was definitely helpful. But I gave up because...
Well, you probably didn't do it at home, I'm assuming.
I didn't do it at home the way I was supposed to.
Yeah.
And the fights with insurance. And then I got busy with, like, work in the real world, in college.
I think you stopped long before that.
I was going in college.
Wow.
But then with College of Lamb and, like, everything, I was like, this isn't worth it.
If you were going then, why didn't they do something about your wrists?
Well, they told me to wear splints, but I didn't wear splints.
Oh.
I'm not a very good patient. If you have not ascertained that in all of my videos.
Okay.
Alright, that's the knee. Let's do the thigh. You're going to show what you're stretching.
I'm pushing down on Shane's... This leg is like in the way.
Yeah, yeah.
But
you should use that leg for this one.
Yeah, true. I'm pushing down on Shane's hip flexor.
On my pelvic region.
Yeah.
I'm just going to make sure I get that in the keywords for this video. Pelvic region. Disabled pelvic region. Hot girl touches pelvic region.
Please stop. Anyway, Shane's hips are tight. He can actually go this way quite far. I guess that makes sense because he's sick.
That's one of my specialties.
Oh, can we also show them how you can cross your legs? Because that blows my mind.
Yeah, is this one? This is not part of my therapy.
Or is it this one?
And it just really likes this. This is what I do when I'm feeling a bit fancy.
Can you believe that he could cross his legs this way? I can smack your butt. I literally can't believe it. There's no world in which this should be possible. For you.
For all of you who have asked about how we're intimate.
No.
Here it is.
It doesn't have to do with the cross leg. Okay.
So yeah, she's just pulling down on my leg now.
Yeah.
Really to stretch out the top of my thigh, which is another problem area. I'm covered in problem areas.
Should we do your feet?
Yeah. All right, she got bored of that one fast.
Yeah.
All right, so the foot, we're just, is it even in the video?
Yeah.
We're just moving it in circles.
I do this with my feet. It feels good. Does this feel good?
It feels very good.
Good. You normally hate your feet being touched.
I know, but I've gotten better about that.
Yep. I've forced it upon you until you have decided you like it.
And it was really into touching my feet.
No,
so.
Shane has very delicate feet.
I do.
And so.
No, I do.
Well, because you never let anyone touch them, I think.
Yeah.
Sort of like how you wouldn't let anyone touch your back.
Yeah.
And so it felt weird. And then I just kept touching it and touching it until your nerves were like, oh, this is like normal touch. It's fine.
Do you want to explain the background to that so they understand?
Your back?
Yeah.
Shane has a scar in his back from his spinal fusion. And his scar tissue feels weird when you touch it. Or at least it used to. Now you're fine with it.
Now I'm fine. Because it has, what's that called?
Willful.
No.
The
type of therapy.
Exposure therapy. Yep.
I'd wake up and she would just be lifting my scar.
All night long. Never took a break. And it worked.
So I do this therapy whenever we remember, which is not very often.
Yeah.
Although Hannah remembers more than me, and she'll be like, want me to stretch you? And I'll be like, nah, not right now.
Yeah.
But anyway.
So that happens for about 3 months, and then Shane finally says yes.
But we'll usually do it right when I wake up, or right before we go to bed.
Yep.
My head. Do you want to do that? My neck.
Oh, this?
Yeah.
I'll pull his head one direction and push his legs the other. That is 100% going to get a bunch of physical therapists to be like, don't do that. Good way to decapitate someone.
This is the one that feels the best, though, obviously.
Yeah.
Pull my head a little
bit. But you have a spinal rod. Right. This probably shouldn't be, but probably this is bad. The other way doesn't do anything because Shane's not tight the other way.
Yeah.
Like, pushing your head. Does that feel good?
Yeah, I have way more range of motion that way. Oh, the last thing that we do sometimes, so you push this pillow down if you're sinking in, is a bicycle.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. I forgot about that.
This is what This is normally what we do when we don't feel like doing stretches.
Yeah.
It's just to loosen me up.
Range of motion.
In an easier way.
Yeah.
And if I close my eyes, I can imagine that I can ride a bike through the wilderness. And now we're on a beach. I'm racing away from Hannah.
Oh my
God. Sometimes when we do this, I can, like, physically,
guide me?
Like, guide? Yeah, like, I actually use my muscles to make my legs do this. Hannah is 100% doing this, but I can, like, help a little bit.
Yeah, that's good.
Which is, I have no idea if it's helpful.
Or you can hinder, you can yank back. I can make it a lot more difficult.
I'm kissing your left boob every time.
It's my right boob.
It's your right boob?
Yep.
They switch? Well, this is a video you always wanted.
Everyone's like, why are we here? Well,
that feels like... Here, lean forward, balance your head on my knees. This is the thumbnail.
This is the thumbnail?
We're taking our thumbnail photo now.
I don't know if I want this to be the thumbnail. I might overrule that.
Okay, well.
How about this?
That's my therapy routine.
Yep.
Performed by the wonderful Hannah.
Did you want to forget my last name?
No, I'm trying to think of your therapy name. Hannah Hurtsalot.
Wish me luck for the rest of my day. Shane's obviously in some sort of mood. Give me strength. Goodbye.